Question for you. What business couldn't use extra income? Hey, it's Tiki Barber. Right now, Amazon Hub Delivery is looking to partner with ambitious Seattle businesses to become Amazon Hub partners. You and your staff will deliver packages to customers in your area when it's convenient for you. And with each package delivered, your business gets paid. Sign up at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
All right, places, please. The Daly Migs Show is on deck. Guitars plugged in. Ready to go? Chickens?
They're a clucking.
Other animals? And action!
This is the Daly Migs Show on The Rock with Taryn Daly and Steve Migs.
While listening to the Daly Migs Show, please refrain from any unnecessary finger gesturing.
99.9 KISW.
Good morning and happy Tuesday, Rockaholics. Lovely to be with you here this morning, Steve Migs,
yes.
Danny, and Sarah. I have a question for each of you.
Okay.
When it comes to breakfast, eggs, a lot of people eat eggs for breakfast. Do you put ketchup on your eggs or no?
If they're scrambled.
You do?
Oh, yeah.
But not like
back
a regular
when I was eating
egg.
Eggs, yeah, I would totally, if scrambled, I would put, well, I guess I like a bagel, like an egg bagel sandwich, I would put ketchup on it.
Really? Okay.
Omelet.
All right.
Why, you don't?
No, I was just wondering. I like ketchup on hash browns, but not on my eggs.
Ketchup, I don't put on anything, Taryn Daly.
You just really hate ketchup?
Yeah, ketchup's literally the worst condiment of all time.
Oh my God, what is he talking about?
He's from another planet, man.
Thank you. What about you, Sarah?
Sarah, you don't eat eggs.
No, but I'm the exact opposite of Danny, is I love ketchup.
So will you, like, completely destroy hash browns with ketchup like I
will.
Yeah. It's like the salt on the hash browns.
Here's my, why are you asking us this?
I'm just curious.
I feel like you have an agenda and you just want to kind of spit out your own agenda.
No, it's like that my husband goes crazy with ketchup on eggs and it like really upsets me. I mean, I like
hot sauce.
Maybe
you're not cooking them well enough for him.
No. You know what? If anybody cooks a good egg, it's the lady with the chickens, okay, Migs?
I don't know. Your husband's dousing it with ketchup, trying to mask that terrible taste.
And at the end of the day, though, eat whatever makes you happy, but I was just wondering how.
I don't know. I got a very judgmental tone in your voice when you were asking this question.
Oh, my God. Well, I mean, I do think that ketchup is a superior condiment, though. Mm-hmm. So Danny and I are going to disagree on that forever. Mm-hmm. But I just don't think it goes on eggs.
I feel like ketchup's a good plan B condiment.
What?
What's plan A?
Anything else.
Wow. Thank you, Steve.
But I like ketchup. But like if I'm at like French fries, like ranch, I think is even better.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Wait, how do you guys feel about ketchup on your mac and cheese?
No.
What?
No.
Oh, it's so good.
I've never done it.
You've never done it?
No.
Yeah, if you're three, it's a really big thing.
3 or 30-something. It's great.
Sometimes taste buds never change.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
Huh. So good. Oh, you have to try it. Next time you have mac and fake cheese.
I can't judge because for the longest time, everyone was talking about putting ketchup like on a grilled cheese. I'm like, that sounds stupid.
Good.
And then I was in Canada, of all places. I remember one time I got a grilled cheese and they put ketchup on it without me asking. And I was like, I took a bite out of it thinking I'm going to just hate this. I was like, this is phenomenal.
Wait, they just put it on it without...
That's just how they serve the grilled cheese sandwich when I was there.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
You learn something new every day.
I don't know if that's like a Canadian thing. Like by law, they put ketchup on their grilled cheese. But the place that I was at, just forever ago, they did that.
That's amazing.
So you don't like ketchup on your scrambled eggs?
No.
Weird.
But I like hot sauce on them.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. All right. Well, I just wanted to poll the room real quickly before we inform the Rockaholics.
Knowledge is power. So give us 5-ish minutes and we'll give you
Some interesting stuff you can talk about at work. This is the Daily Migs Download.
A.K.A. the DMD.
Here's your daily dose of doings happening in the world.
And the DMV is brought to you by Palace Lawn. Today is a day. Do you put ketchup on your vanilla ice cream?
No.
Okay, good.
What?
Because today is National Vanilla Ice Cream Day, which is, I mean, you just can't go wrong with a simple scoop of vanilla, if you ask me.
Oh, yeah. And then a little rainbow sprinkles, maybe, if you got them.
Oh, man. Talk about being three again.
Getting crazy over here.
But it is delicious. Okay, Mariners. Stop losing. Stop blowing leads. Stop wasting great pitching efforts by guys like Bryce Miller. He pitched seven scoreless innings. The Mariners ended up screwing it up towards the end of the game, including a two-out single in the ninth inning by Joe Adele, who ended up helping the Los Angeles Angels beat the Mariners 3-1. They play again. The bummer part is Houston lost as well, so this could have been a chance for the Mariners to jump ahead of them in the first place race, but nope, they didn't do that. They play again tonight, but then they're also playing tomorrow afternoon, and all of us from the Daily Migs Show, we're going to be there tomorrow afternoon, so come find us. We'll probably be hanging out in the pen, and we won't even make it to our seats like we usually do.
We're just going
to
be going on a food tour, tasting all the delicious treats.
Yep.
Delta Airlines had a rough day yesterday. This is 3 days after the global cyber outage that led them to cancel 800 flights. We do have some audio of some frustrated travelers who were dealing with those cancellations while in Atlanta.
It's been a mess. It's been crazy. I've never had this kind of experience traveling before.
I sat here from 5 o'clock yesterday and I'm still here.
Feeling a little bit vulnerable. I ain't got my luggage and it's kind of important to me.
I wonder what's in his luggage that's so important. Probably just toiletries.
Yeah.
I don't know why I was thinking like he's got like something
drugs.
Special.
No.
Secret information. That would be so frustrating if you didn't have your luggage.
Oh,
and you just stuck somewhere. Oh, I'd be so pissed. How about this story? Thank you, Tacoma, for giving us a story that is now going national, because I saw this on a couple of like national news sites as well. A human finger was found in Tacoma, but thankfully it's been returned to its owner. So everybody rejoice.
Probably a little too late to reattach it, though.
How about they found it on July 5th? So they believe, yeah, it had to do with a fireworks accident. But the weird part is that local hospitals had no record of anybody losing their finger in this kind of an injury or whichever finger it was on the 4th of July. So, like, what in the world is going on? Apparently, though, the owner of the finger saw the story on the news and came forward to claim his finger.
What?
He's anonymous, but I got to wonder, like, what was he? Did he go to the hospital after he blew his finger off? Or did he just kind of do it? Did he deal with it at home?
I mean, it sounds like he dealt with it at home. Maybe he just cauterized it.
That might be the most gangster thing we're going to hear today.
Oh, my gosh.
Hey, as far as weather, we're going to hit a high of 74 degrees. It's going to be sunny. The DMV is brought to you by Kia Puyallup, and that's what's up.
We just came across something that is quite possibly the most impressive while also the most immature thing that we have ever heard. Do you have any idea what it is, Steve?
I mean, it could be the catch-up conversation this morning.
It involves man's best friend.
Okay.
And you're going to hear all about it at 6:20.
The Daily Migs Show.
Question for you. What business couldn't use extra income? Hey, it's Tiki Barber. Right now, Amazon Hub Delivery is looking to partner with ambitious Seattle businesses to become Amazon Hub partners. You and your staff will deliver packages to customers in your area when it's convenient for you. And with each package delivered, your business gets paid. Sign up at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
Selling a little or a lot? Shopify helps you do your thing, however you cha-ching. Shopify is the global commerce platform that helps you sell at every stage of your business. From the launch your online shop stage, to the first real-life store stage, all the way to the did we just hit a million orders stage. Shopify is here to help you grow. Whether you're selling scented soap or offering outdoor outfits, Shopify helps you sell everywhere. From their all-in-one e-commerce platform to their in-person POS system, wherever and whatever you're selling, Shopify's got you covered. Shopify helps you turn browsers into buyers with the internet's best converting checkout. 15% better on average compared to other leading commerce platforms. And sell more with less effort thanks to Shopify Magic, your AI-powered all-star. Shopify powers 10% of all e-commerce in the U.S. And Shopify is the global force behind Allbirds, Rothy's, and Brooklinen, and millions of other entrepreneurs of every size across 175 countries. Plus, Shopify's award-winning 24/7 help is there to support your success every step of the way. Because businesses that grow, grow with Shopify. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/odysseypodcast, all lowercase. Go to shopify.com/odysseypodcast now to grow your business, no matter what stage you're in. Shopify.com/odysseypodcast.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
There's a good chance this will be the most immature and impressive thing you've ever heard in your entire life, Rockaholics. There is a video that has gone viral of a dog farting for 18 seconds.
I saw the story title and the headline. I'm like, there's no way. There's no chance in hell that a dog can fart that long.
Want to hear it?
Yeah, of course I do.
This is the audio.
What are they feeding this dog?
What just
right?
happened?
Right?
And you're probably thinking to yourself, well, someone hand him the Guinness World Record for longest fart, but that category doesn't even exist.
Oh, darn.
In a weird way, I'm kind of surprised that it doesn't already.
Totally surprised by that.
Although I don't think, still, it sounded like a cicada attack. It didn't even sound like a fart.
Do either of your dogs have flatulence issues?
I mean, nothing to that extent. It's usually like a quick one. And it's so few and far between. So when it does happen, it's pretty hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Of the three labs I've owned in my adult life, they were all like silent farters. So I don't know how long the farts were going. I have no idea.
Lulu cracked me up when she was a puppy. If she ever, anytime she farted, it would freak her the F out and she'd start barking. Like as if like somebody's behind her, like kind of like for like she's like, what was that? And I'm just like, it came out of your rear end. Like, how do you not know?
It kind of reminds me of that scene from Step Brothers when they're in the job interview. And is it Seth Rogen that's interviewing
yeah.
them?
Yeah. So let's do this. You know, you guys are hired. You're in, you know, unless you're like the weirdest guys ever and I don't see it.
Great.
And mind you, they're wearing tuxedos at this moment.
Great.
Was that a fart?
I don't know.
I mean, that dog put that to shame. That was Hollywood.
So weird that that even exists on the internet now.
Well, and I just want everyone to know, in case you were wondering, there is a world record for longest fart for a human.
Okay.
Can you guys guess how long that is?
Oh man.
Sarah.
I got it.
46 seconds.
Steve, remember back to when you did it. And remember if you
I know, dude, how long it is.
I
am trying to think of some of the ones that have completely annoyed the living hell out of my wife. Because there have been a few where she's like, are you still going? But even then, I'm going to go 50. Man, that sounds too excessive, actually. I'm going 38 seconds.
2 minutes
no.
and 48 seconds.
There's no way.
By a guy named Bernard Clemens.
Imagine that's your claim to fame.
No, I would hate that. And I would hate that for his significant other if he has one. Two minutes and 48 seconds?
How do you... So they had to bring somebody there to... Because in order for it to be a Guinness Book of World Records, either somebody has to film it, and there has to be like somebody there to like to mark that this legitimately happened. So somebody had to happen. Had to be there while this guy was doing this. And I can't imagine every time was just like a home run.
No.
Right?
He probably had to practice and try until... He thought he was going to win.
Is there a way to find out if this guy's married or single? Or,
let me do some research. Right.
This also makes me very curious about the folks that are the judges for the Guinness World Records. I mean, is there a certain number of attempts that you get when you're trying to set a record? We gotta talk to one of these people.
I would call in sick if they said, hey, you got to go over to like Wisconsin. And I don't know why Wisconsin's the first place I thought of, but, you know, geez.
And he does have a wife and kids. So they're probably very proud.
Oh, I bet the kids are proud.
Oh, for sure.
I'm willing to bet the wife is not.
I mean, you're in the Guinness Book of World Records, though. That's pretty cool. Even if it's for...
Would you be impressed if George was able to do... I mean, you were happy that he won a donut eating competition.
Yeah, but that's different. That's badass. And you know, if
I'm not
he,
sure if that is badass that he ate a bunch of mini donuts, but
if
it's
he
cool.
was proud of himself, you know, I would have to be the supportive wife.
Okay. I don't believe you.
No. Did any of you ever set a record with anything like in high school or
No.
Have you?
Not that I can remember.
That's cute that you think we're like that.
She asked very judgmental. Yeah. Like, did you guys ever do anything that cool?
I was pretty sure you were asking that question because you wanted us to follow up with, did you? And she's like, well, actually, there was this time in college that I swallowed.
Well, I mean, that's seven goldfish, but that doesn't really count. That was unsanctioned.
Oh, okay.
Rockaholics, quick show of hands. Who out there would like to win Megadeth tickets? All you have to do... is call us now, 206-803-ROCK. But there is a stipulation. You must be over the age of 30, as we're going to put you to the test to see just how hip you are. If you know what the younger generation is saying.
What the fellow kids are saying.
If you know what the youths are saying, you could win Megadeth tickets. 206-803-ROCK. We're going to play What the F is Gen Z Saying after Van Halen.
The Daily Migs Show.
Alexa has just unveiled a new feature, and it's designed to help parents communicate with their teenagers. All you have to do is say, Alexa, talk Gen Z to me.
So like a Gen Z translator.
Yes.
I'm a little worried as Tatum gets older, like, how is this going to go? Like, what kind of words is she going to use?
So Alexa will spit out the slang word and then give the definition of the word. And then you're all learned up on the Gen Z talk.
Then you're hip with the kids.
Yeah, totally. So we wanted to see just how in touch our rockaholics are with Gen Z with a game that we're going to call What the F is Gen Z Saying?
Hey, Gen Z, what the f*** are you saying to talk like this back in the day? Is it cap or no cap, cringe, you're vibing? Hey, Gen Z, what the f*** are you saying? Danny V, is it robots rule? Danny V, is it robots rule?
Did I hear a chicken at the beginning of this? I heard like a buck, buck, buck.
No, you didn't.
I swear to God, at the beginning of like, it was like in the first couple of seconds of it.
Wow.
Wait, did the robot just do that too?
It did.
This AI is getting crazy. Let's see. Hold on.
Hey, Jazzy, what the f*** are you saying to talk like this back in the day? Is it cap or no cap?
I lost it this time. I heard it at the beginning.
You might just have rooster on your mind.
You know, it was Terrence's chicken question earlier, or egg question.
Like, I didn't hear a bok bok.
I swear to God, I heard a chicken in it.
Danny, you need sleep.
All right.
So we have two worthy competitors on the phone. We have Tina in Tacoma and Angie on I-5. And we're going to ask each of you a Gen Z term, and you have to guess what it means. The first to get two right will win Megadeth tickets. Tina and Angie, are you ready?
Yes.
Yep.
Hey, can we ask? I know it's not polite to ask a lady how old they are, but just to get a little context, since we are talking about Gen Z, which is what, like 27 and younger? Yep. So, Tina, how old are you? Or around how old?
I'm 52.
52, right on. And Angie?
I will be 47 next week.
Okay, so you both are a step away from the Gen Z generation.
All right, yeah. Tina, we're going to start with you. What does the Gen Z word ick mean?
Ick.
Ick. I-C-K.
Oh, God. Icky? I don't know. Ick.
Well, yeah, what is icky, though? What is icky?
I don't even know this. Ick. I'm at a loss here. I have no idea.
Oh, man. Yeah, you can't just say the same word but add a Y to it. You got to kind of still describe what it is. It's okay if you don't know these. I mean, I think you're better off not knowing Gen Z terms.
Wrong. All right. All right. We're going to Angie.
So what does ick mean?
Oh, ick means disgust.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was going to say that.
Angie, your word is tea.
It's what?
T-E-A. Like the drink, tea.
Oh, it's gossip.
Yeah. All right, we're back to Tina. Your word is sus. Spelled S-U-S. Sus.
Oh, my goodness. Bonk?
Bonk?
Bonk, like, oh, that's bonk.
Wrong.
It means suspicious.
And I love you.
Back awesome. To Angie. Angie, your next word is mid.
Can you spell that for me, please?
M-I-D.
I want to say it's so simple, but I bet you it's not. Like the middle? Midriff? Middle? I don't know.
It means mediocre.
Yeah.
We're going back to Tina. Tina, what does the word riz mean?
Oh, God.
Spelled R-I-Z-Z.
Let's go.
Riz. These are tough.
They have these younger kids. They speak a whole different language.
I can't even guess. Ooh, that's riz. Flow, I don't know.
No.
It means charisma.
That one took a minute for me to even kind of put the two and two together. When I finally did it, I'm like, oh, okay, that makes sense.
Angie, your word is drip. D-R-I-P, drip.
D-R-T.
D as in dog, drip.
Like,
couple more seconds. You don't know?
Pain? I don't know.
Oh, this is painful, man.
Trendy or high class fashion.
I say to put all of us out of our misery. If Tina gets this one wrong, that means Angie at least got one right and she wins the tickets.
All right, Tina, your word is eight. Spelled A-T-E.
I could use it in a sentence.
Okay.
You want me to use it in a sentence? No.
Oh, I thought she said she was going to.
Oh, you were going to use it in a sentence.
Let's go, Tina.
That movie was so eight. So it's like...
No, I'm not even
close. Eight means to praise someone for doing something well or with style. Like, you ate with that outfit. Or you can take it a step further and say, you ate and left no crumbs.
Oh, Tina's words, I felt like she ate this game.
Angie, one more for you here. Mother. What does mother mean?
Mother. Well, I mean, definitely not mom, but... Mother,
Angie, it's okay.
It's okay.
You know what? We
already said the fact that you got one right and Tina got none wrong.
Yeah.
None right, you're walking away with the tickets.
Congratulations, okay, Angie.
I did know what sus means, though. I did know what sus. I wish I would have got that word.
I think I agree with the robots when they said,
wow.
And mother apparently means someone who's iconic or like a mentor. Like, you might call someone like Rihanna mother.
Someone said, man, I would have had these tickets so fast. I'm 33.
Yeah. God. Me too. I wish I could have helped them.
Did you have all of them?
I did not know eight.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
But now
stupid.
I do.
I've never heard eight until today. Today, years old. Well, congratulations, everyone. We're now a little bit smarter in the world of Gen Z.
I mean...
Rockaholics, we would love for someone to challenge Steve to a game of Beat Migs this morning. He's got a record of 197 wins, 57 losses, and 32 ties in 2024. 206-803-ROCK. We're going to play Beat Migs at 6:50.
Yes, the Daily Migs Show.
Hey, it's Tiki Barber with a special message for Seattle businesses looking to diversify your income. Amazon Hub Delivery is making it easy to earn extra money. When you partner with Amazon Hub Delivery, you and your staff will deliver packages to customers in your area. With each package delivered, you'll gain extra income and exposure for your business. There's no upfront cost, no delivery experience, and no long-term contracts required. Sign up to learn more at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
Hey, it's Tiki Barber with two words any business owner wants to hear. Extra income. Amazon Hub Delivery is looking for Seattle businesses to assist with local deliveries. You get paid for each package delivered. Amazon Hub Delivery has no startup cost, no long-term contracts, and no delivery experience required. If you're a Seattle business ready to assist with local deliveries, sign up today at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
Rockaholics, we encourage you to log in and listen to KISW for your shot at winning your share of $100,000. This is so easy. You just create or log into your free account on the Odyssey app and start listening. You can get more info on the contest at KISW.com.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
To beat Migs. I know Christine on I-5 is. Christine, are you there?
I am here.
I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
Bye-bye.
For those playing at home, Christine has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Let's go.
What chocolate bar is also the same name as a galaxy?
Mars.
No.
Oh, keep going? Milky Way.
Correct. There are approximately how many weeks in a year?
52.
Correct. Mark Spitz won 9 Olympic gold medals competing in what sport?
Track.
No.
Swimming.
Correct. The Hundred Years' War of the 14th and 15th centuries were primarily a conflict between England and what other country?
Shoot, I have no Spain, I'll say. Oh, keep guessing. Spain,
No, you can also pass.
Pass.
What'd she say? What local late musician would have turned 60 this past weekend?
Late musician would have turned 60 this past weekend. No clue.
Pass. You want to pass?
Pass.
Mutton is pass. Meat from what animal?
What is meat from what animal?
Mutton is meat from what animal?
Is that a goat?
It is not. And what were the two she said for the England and what other country?
I heard Spain.
Spain. And did you say another one?
I tried to say Portugal, but that's it.
Oh, well, that would have been wrong anyway. Yeah. So, Christine, you got three correct.
All right.
Oh my Lord. Okay.
I think she was a little confused with the instructions, maybe. But, you know, we kind of got through it.
We did.
I don't think we did.
It was a struggle, but
there's some of it.
Steve, I'm rooting for you right now.
Oh, rooting for me. Oh,
I'm rooting for you.
Okay.
Yeah. Are you ready?
I appreciate that.
Oh yeah.
Let's go.
What chocolate bar is also the same name as a galaxy?
Mars.
No.
Milky
is
Way.
Mars a galaxy? No. Yes. There are approximately how many weeks in a year?
52.
Correct. Mark Spitz won 9 Olympic gold medals competing in what sport?
Swimming.
Yes. The Hundred Years' War of the 14th and 15th centuries were primarily a conflict between England and what other country?
France?
What? Yes.
Ah,
what local late musician would have turned 60 this past weekend?
Chris Cornell.
Correct. Mutton is meat from what animal?
Oh. Ox?
No.
Mutton?
Mutton.
Deer?
No.
Mutton. bull.
No.
Cow?
No. Damn the it. Reality show Top Chef airs on what network?
Is that on, AMC?
No.
The cooking channel?
No.
Fox?
No. The human ear consists of how many bones?
One.
No.
None.
No.
10.
No.
I don't know.
Woo,
started off pretty good.
It did. It did. So did for Christine as well. But you got 5 correct, which is a win. 5-3. Christine, it was closer than I thought it was going to be.
Oh, terrible.
I mean, I didn't want to say it.
I'm the best. I'm the best.
Christine also said Mars for galaxy. That's why I was like, I know that's a planet. Is that some sneaky galaxy I don't know about?
It was just the first thing I thought of because of a Mars bar. I was like, okay, I just throw something out there to kind of stall. I don't know who I'm stalling. I have 60 seconds whether or not I get it right.
True.
Yeah.
Mutton is the meat from what animal?
Sheep.
Yes.
It's what they call it, mutton busting at the rodeo when the kids come out holding on to the sheep and they run them. It's great.
Have you had mutton?
No. I don't think so. I don't think so.
You seem like you would try it.
No, but I want my child to try mutton busting.
Is that where they put the helmet on? They ride a sheep like it's like a horse?
Exactly.
I've always seen that like being on display, like, hey, you know, and at like a fair. And I'm just like, I kind of want to see that, but I also don't know if I want to see that. It just seems very strange.
Pretty funny.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
The reality top show airs on
Food Network?
Bravo.
Bravo.
Yes.
That's the channel I was trying to think of. I couldn't think of it, though.
Yep. And the human ear consists of how many bones?
Two?
Three.
What are they? The stirrup?
Girl, I don't have that on my notes.
Wow.
I have no idea. But
man, I'm watching now videos of mutton busting. It just seems like such a terrible idea. These poor kids are like holding on for dear life onto these sheep that are going surprisingly faster than I thought. And they have a hockey helmet on and really a vest that's barely any padding to it.
It looks very dangerous.
I mean, they're very much training these kids for bull riding.
Yeah. And you want Barrett to do it?
Just because it's so cute.
The poor kid's hugging the sheep for dear life, and the poor sheep, too.
You got to dig your fingers into the wool.
Oh, is that what we're doing?
Yeah, that's strategy, baby.
And then it's just like, they don't last very long.
No, they don't. Oh, and sometimes they get trampled.
Yeah.
Well, good luck, Barrett.
That's fun for everybody to watch children just getting mauled by sheep.
Yeah.
Earlier this morning, I asked everyone on the show if they have ever held a record. And Migs, we actually got a text about this.
We did. Someone texted in while we were talking about it. And it was just like, oh, actually, I do hold a record. And I was like, that's pretty impressive. And where the hell did the text go? I lost it.
It was the guy, he said his freshman year in high school, he got pinned in a wrestling match in 7 seconds.
Yes.
And that record stood for 20 years before another wrestler was pinned in 6 seconds.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. Very impressive. So we wanted to hear from you about this, Rockaholics. Call us up now. 206-803-ROCK. What record have you ever held? We're going to take your calls after Tool.
The Daily Mix Show.
odd, or awesome, what record have you ever held? 206-803-ROCK. This question is stemming from a text that we got this morning that was quite impressive.
Yep, the person said in freshman year, I got pinned in a wrestling match in 7 seconds. That's quick.
I thought, yeah, that's lightning.
And they said that record stood for 20 years until another record was pinned in six seconds. Do you call that person and say, hey, thank you? Or do you say, damn it? I don't know. I feel like if you're not gonna be the best at it, you might as well be the worst and then have that record forever. Everyone's gonna still remember your name.
For sure.
Yeah.
You know, I do actually remember a record that I did hold, but it was for not very long. When Stanwood High School first got like a legitimate swim team,
mm-hmm.
Basically everybody had the record because it was the first names on the board.
It's like when the Kraken started and like this is the first guy in Kraken history that he just scored a goal. I'm like, yes, of course. This is game one, of course.
So I did hold a relay record with my relay team for like, 2 years. Very exciting.
I didn't know you were on the swim team.
I was a backstroker, baby.
Wow.
Stroking all the backs.
I bet you were. You continue to do that in Washington State University, I hear.
Oof, no. I did compete at districts once, but I was pretty bad.
Did you have to wear, like, the cap?
Of course.
Okay, I'm just curious.
And then the swimsuit that's, like, two sizes too small because they want you to have, like, not a lot of drag.
Oh, okay, so you probably, that's kind of uncomfortable to be in front of, like, all the friends and family, and you have to wear, like, basically next to nothing.
When you first pull the swimsuit out of the package when it's brand new, too, it looks like it goes on, like, a doll.
You're like, how am I going to fit in this?
Someone's going to have to...
Mm-hmm.
Give me a hand.
We got a couple text messages at 206-803-ROCK. One person said I had a Pac-Man record in high school. That was pretty cool. Another texter says, back in 92 when I was in the 8th grade, we did track and field for PE. I beat the school discus record by 9 feet. Everyone was making a huge deal out of this, and then I was informed, well, it didn't count as a record because it didn't happen in an official track meet, and that's from Redbeard.
Oh, brutal.
I have a stupid one.
Okay.
It's unofficial. It was when I was in elementary school. They used to serve on hamburger day. They used to give you these little tiny cups. Like, what you take like a Jell-O shot out of.
Mm-hmm.
But they were filled with lettuce and pickles. I had the record for the most eating of those little cups. And I ate 45 of them during lunch one day.
So you ate 45 cups of pickles and lettuce?
Yeah. No hamburger with it.
Were you challenged to this, or were you trying to impress somebody? Like, what was the backstory behind it?
I don't remember, to be honest with you. Uh-huh. I think that it was just because I really like pickles, and I just started to eat. And
sweet
I would
pickles,
ask,
right?
No, dill pickles, the only kind of pickles. And I would ask everyone around me, can I have your pickles and lettuce? And so they just started stacking them up. And I remember everyone was like, 10, 11. And I was just eating them. And I got 45 of them down before the bell rang and we had to go to recess.
So you ate the same amount of those little tiny cups as Sarah's husband ate of mini donuts?
Yeah, except there was way less calories.
Way less. vegetarian even.
I feel like you're like on like a weird high school or elementary school episode of Man versus Food where everyone's gathered around just kind of like amping you up and telling you to do it.
Yeah, it was pretty awesome. I mean, I still have the trophy somewhere. No, there was no trophy.
You just got cooler, Danny.
We can make you a trophy.
That's sweet.
Have you ever wondered this? How actors stay, we'll call it cool, during a steamy scene in the movies or TV shows?
Yes.
Honestly, there are times where I watch a certain movie or a television show, I'm like... This seems a little much.
They actually have intimacy coordinators. That's a real job. And they have a trick that they use to keep things professional on the set. We're going to tell you what that trick is at 7:20.
The Daily Migs Show.
Hey, it's Tiki Barber with two words any business owner wants to hear. Extra income. Amazon Hub Delivery is looking for Seattle businesses to assist with local deliveries. You get paid for each package delivered. Amazon Hub Delivery has no startup cost, no long-term contracts, and no delivery experience required. If you're a Seattle business ready to assist with local deliveries, sign up today at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
Selling a little or a lot? Shopify helps you do your thing, however you cha-ching. Shopify is the global commerce platform that helps you sell at every stage of your business. From the launch your online shop stage, to the first real-life store stage, all the way to the did we just hit a million orders stage. Shopify is here to help you grow. Whether you're selling scented soap or offering outdoor outfits, Shopify helps you sell everywhere. From their all-in-one e-commerce platform to their in-person POS system, wherever and whatever you're selling, Shopify's got you covered. Shopify helps you turn browsers into buyers with the internet's best converting checkout. 15% better on average compared to other leading commerce platforms. And sell more with less effort thanks to Shopify Magic, your AI-powered all-star. Shopify powers 10% of all e-commerce in the U.S. And Shopify is the global force behind Allbirds, Rothy's, and Brooklinen, and millions of other entrepreneurs of every size across 175 countries. Plus, Shopify's award-winning 24/7 help is there to support your success every step of the way. Because businesses that grow, grow with Shopify. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/odysseypodcast, all lowercase. Go to shopify.com/odysseypodcast now to grow your business, no matter what stage you're in. Shopify.com/odysseypodcast.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Has it ever crossed your mind how an actor might handle getting excited while filming a steamy scene for a movie?
I always just thought they'd say taped everything down, like flesh color tape, just to be safe.
I love that you thought about this.
Oh, yeah. You've never thought about it? Like watching a scene, you're just like, how do you not? Like, I guess like it's a weird environment because you're surrounded by camera people and lighting and all that. But still, like, I mean, you're getting into it.
I mean, I guess I never really thought about it until right now. Other than the fact that I just assumed actors and actresses are like so professional that they could like, you know, shut it off. But maybe I'm wrong.
So they got like some Jedi mind power.
they have.
But see, I think as a woman, maybe it's easy. It's I don't want to say harder. More difficult for a guy to hide his excitement.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Right, Danny? Like, I mean, I think for us, like if I'm like, if you're in like a steamy scene in a movie with Jessica Biel, I don't know why she's the first person I popped into mind.
But I'll take it.
Right, right. As much as you don't want to be that person,
yeah.
If things are being, if things get brushed and touched and, you know, everything's happening, you just don't know what's
going
to happen.
I mean, if we're going with Jessica Biel, if you watch any of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, just her running in her her shirt, I don't think I'd be able to be on the same set with her.
That'll do it.
Yeah.
You'd be like, I need the intimacy coordinator, please.
That's the hired help that they have. The intimacy coordinator. That is a real job.
And how do you get that job? I can't. I wouldn't get it.
No, you could talk to her. Her name is Brooke Haney.
Oh, okay.
Not Heine, Haney.
That's funny.
She says what she tells the actor to do is a few push-ups or some jumping jacks before filming that scene because it will help move the blood to a different location of the body, and then you're all good to go.
Like, look, I get the blood is pumping into something in your body. We need to get that blood to pump somewhere else.
But
I'd actually be a good intimacy coordinator.
Would you?
Yeah. Hmm. Like, just look at me. You'll lose any kind of excitement. Keep looking at me.
I thought you were going to just say you're just going to punch him right before. No. Oh, no. Wrestle them right before. Show up in your singlet.
Do you remember when you were a kid? Like, not kid, but like a teen. They'd be like, oh, you know, here's like, I think of baseball or I think of Grandma Naked.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Those are like the, I don't know if you've ever heard those things.
I mean,
before.
Yes, I have.
Okay.
Grandma Naked.
Grandma Naked playing baseball.
Oh.
Man, that's a visual.
Ew.
Right?
I also don't know that it worked ever. That was the thing, too. It was just like, I mean, maybe my other thoughts were too intrusive. Whereas, like, I mean, I can try to think about something else, but it's not working.
Especially teen version of yourself. Like, there's just no help. No. There's no hope.
Well, and I'm going to say, if you think about, you know, your grandma naked at one moment, but then I'm over here making out with Ryan Gosling or something, grandma's out of my mind. I'm just, making out with, you know what I mean? Like, it'll work for a second, but then just be in that moment.
That part of your brain's like, get out of here, grandma. I got other things to worry about.
Yeah, I'm with Ryan right now.
And you say Ryan Gosling, like, some of those scenes in The Notebook were, wow.
All right, here's a question for you guys. I actually saw it, so I don't feel like I'm getting older. It's my because I've been reading, like, I read a study where it was like Gen Zers are saying that they're just not into sex scenes anymore. They just think they're kind of weird. Like half of Gen Zers, they were like, I guess, surveyed, and they said, yeah, you know what? I could live without any of the sex scenes in movies. It's just kind of unnecessary.
I feel like I choose movies and shows because of what sex scenes there are.
Yeah, you know what ruined it? Pornhub. Because at the end of the day, it's just all free for them nowadays. Where it was like, oh, we can see a half boob on a staticky TV. I'm so excited.
Oh, I remember like Basic Instinct being like, this is the greatest scene ever. I'm going to just keep watching this over and over and over. And this is better than anything I'd ever be able to get my hands on.
What about Wild Things?
Yeah, or the pool scene in...
Cruel Intentions?
No, in Showgirls.
Oh, yeah.
One of the greatest films of all time, of course. But I thought that was interesting that a lot of Gen Zers are just like, yeah, you know, there's other ways. If I want to see a steamy scene in a show, I'll just watch adult content. I could live without it in my television shows and in my movies. And I kind of feel the same way. Like, whenever like a sex scene comes on in a movie, I'm like... All right, like we could save at least 10 minutes in this film if we just get rid of the scene. Like, I get it. You guys are about to bone. Like, how about we just move on to the next scene now?
No, Steve. Wow. What is wrong with
you? So you guys still enjoy watching sex scenes?
Absolutely. That's the whole reason I watch, like, Outlander and Bridgerton.
I turn into a 13-year-old boy again. I'm like, oh, my God, it's happening. Turn it up.
And it's like, yes, there's Pornhub and stuff, but you don't ever, like, you're not happy to see, you know, maybe a beautiful, famous actress get it on, really?
I mean, there are some beautiful actresses, Sarah. You shut your mouth.
Well, yes, but, you know, Ryan Gosling isn't going to be on Pornhub. Like,
well, someone who looks like him might be. No.
I'll take that.
For real, like, once a sex scene starts on a TV show or in a movie, I'm just like, oh, man, okay, this is just extending this film. I can live without. I'm just like, let's just keep it. Let's
extend something.
I'm here for the extension. I really am.
All right. All I guess I'm me and the Gen Zers.
Yeah. So young.
Yes.
Fellow youth.
Surrounded by some old fuddy duddies that just love movies that have boning in it.
Is there a meal that you love to eat where others think you're a little bit crazy for eating it? Is there? Steve Mage?
Well, yes, of course.
What's your weird thing?
Everything now. Yeah. Anytime I tell, because I go, that's not real meat. Why are you eating it? I want protein. So that's why I'm eating it.
Well, we're actually talking more about the things that Sarah eats. We learned something that Sarah enjoys that's very odd.
Yes.
But we want to see if your taste in food might be even odder than Sarah's, Rockaholics. So give us a call, 206-803-ROCK. Tell us about your weird food habits. We'll take your calls after White Stripes.
The Daily Migs Show.
While we were at the Aqua Sox game this past Sunday, our friend Sarah ate something very odd, and so we wanted to see if you have a stranger food taste than she does, Rockaholics. 206-803-ROCK. So what did Sarah eat?
Here we go. What the hell is Sarah doing?
She is eating Danny's buns.
And there are children here.
There are. Danny is eating his burger without the buns. Yes. So Sarah has taken his buns and is apparently putting just ketchup and relish between the buns.
What are you doing there, Sarah?
Oh, you know, just making the best meal ever.
What's the best meal ever, Sarah?
It is a ketchup sweet relish sandwich.
So that's all. Tell us how you really feel, Taryn. So that's all. You have two buns, and you just filled it with relish and ketchup.
Yes.
Open up your bun. Wait. Spread them buns open.
I'll spread them for you. Oh, my God. It looks so good.
You don't even, like, ask for, like, a slice of cheese or something in there?
Nope. This is all you need. Are you ready? Taryn, you want a bite?
It's going to spill all over you.
I hope it squirts all over your top.
Oh, my God.
Okay, can I try it?
Oh, my God. It doesn't even have enough ketchup relish
Taryn,
in it.
Don't do that.
Oh, yeah, girl.
No, don't do it.
Consensus?
Mm.
Well, she doesn't like it.
She almost threw up.
Oh, no.
It's missing so many things.
No, it's perfect.
Like a burger.
Not meat.
Danny, Steve, you want a bite?
I'm good. Yeah.
Swallow it, Taryn. Swallow it.
Okay. What is happening
I
here?
I felt like I had sweet relish stuck in my teeth for way too long.
And you're not a sweet pickle person.
No, it was raunchy.
Swallow it, Taryn. Swallow it.
206-803-ROCK. Annie and Alan, what is your weird food combination?
I love pineapple and mayonnaise sandwich.
What?
With bread? Or how are we doing this?
Soft white bread. And if you get really adventurous, throw a slice of cheese on it.
What? Where did you first discover this combination?
I'm from Alabama, so that's common.
Is it really?
Wow. Yeah, it's quite amazing. You'll have to try it.
My first instinct was I kind of want to see what this tastes like. I don't know why, but I love pineapple. I love mayo.
I feel like there tomorrow you should try it.
So wait, are we talking regular mayo or are we talking Miracle Whip?
Oh, no, not Miracle Whip.
Okay.
Regular mayo.
Can I use the plant-based mayo? Is that going to be okay?
Why not? It's delicious.
I think we should make you try this tomorrow.
I'd be totally down to try it.
All right.
Are you going to bring in the ingredients? Because I'm too lazy to go to the store and get...
White bread.
Yeah.
Vegan mayo.
I could bring that in.
Pineapple.
Yeah. I have no pineapple handy.
I mean, I don't either because I don't eat pineapple.
And she said a slice of cheese if you want to get adventurous.
So that's a thing in Alabama.
It's not surprising.
I've never heard that up until today.
Yeah, to me, it kind of almost reminds me of like almost like a weird potato salad, but it's sweet instead. You know,
yeah.
So Sarah's not the only one that eats weird sandwiches, though. You know who Benny Blanco is?
I only know him because I believe he was on the TV show Dave. If I remember, he's like a record producer. He's kind of out there, kind of a quirky dude.
He posted on TikTok and it's going viral. He showed Selena Gomez a watermelon pickle sandwich where he uses this watermelon as the end caps, as the bread. Here she is trying it.
All right, babe, come try.
I don't want to. I'm not gonna like this, but I love pickles. Okay,
just eat it.
I'm trying.
They're not that bad. We got some on your nose.
It's not that.
Are you like it?
Mm-mm. Is it a sweet pickle or a dill pickle?
Swallow it, Taryn. Swallow it.
It has to be a dill pickle.
Oh. Yeah, I'm guessing it's a dill pickle as well. Well, like, some people like the grill. Have you seen the people who grill watermelon on their... on their grills, to like make it like they grill it like it's a steak or like a burger,
and then
they put it into the burger instead of a like meat.
Yeah. Well, are you guys salt on your watermelon, people?
No.
My mom does that. She'll do salt on her watermelon slices to give it kind of that, you know, to combat the sweet. So it kind of does the same thing with a pickle.
I've heard people do that. I mean, usually I'm just having watermelon by itself or putting tahini on it.
Oh, that's
tahini is amazing on a watermelon.
Game changer. 206-803-ROCK. Jesse in Ording, what is your weird food combo you're into?
So I've got a lot of family in the Midwest and everything else. And then I just, as a kid, I started putting American cheese on my apple pie. And my wife looks at me like I'm some crazy sociopath. And I'm like, what? You got to try it.
So do you have other family members that do that too? Or is it just you?
No, there's a lot on my mom's side that are from like Montana and then they go all the way down to Illinois. And for some reason, they always put cheese on their apple pie. And then the best is if you put a little bit of ice cream on it. But yeah, melted cheese. And I second the salt on watermelon. We do it on like honeydew and cantaloupe and it does something to just like the harder fruits.
Jesse, so you said your wife thinks you're crazy for this. Has she ever at least tried it?
She tried it once, and, you know, it just really wasn't for her. I think it was a texture thing, but I don't know. It's just the way that the cheese and the apple go together. It's American.
It's American cheese and American apple pie.
Every charcuterie board is going to have apples and cheese. That's a good flavor combo. Andy in Tacoma, same question to you. What's your weird food combo?
You know, I put pepper on my cantaloupe, and I really enjoy ketchup on saltine crackers.
Mm-hmm.
Are you pregnant right now, Andy?
Alicia in Seattle, same question to you.
So my favorite is vanilla soft serve ice cream and saltine crackers.
What's up with the saltine crackers, man? Everyone's
into it. But you know, dipping French fries in soft serve, That's really good. I can see that saltine crackers might, you know, be a distant cousin of that combo.
A distant cousin. I mean, they put ice cream on a waffle cone. It's just something crunchy to eat it on.
My mom also does this kind of the same thing, but she does vanilla ice cream in a tortilla with green chili.
Whoa.
Does she roll it?
No, it's like almost like a quesadilla. Huh. She folds it in half, puts it like...
An ice cream quesadilla?
Yeah. She loves it.
Say less. Let's go.
Tim and Everett, what is your crazy food combo?
So I like to take a pickle and put it on a piece of bread with mayonnaise and then put barbecue sauce and mustard on top.
So the pickle is like a hot dog for you.
Right. And I have yet to find a hot dog bun big enough, so I got to use the regular slice of bread.
And wait, are we talking dill pickle?
Yes, the big brown dill pickles you find in the plastic jar.
Yeah. And you can't find a hot dog bun that'll fit that?
Not yet. The bun falls apart. Got to use regular bread.
Oh. Maybe like a French toast, like a baguette, like a French bread.
I love this.
Rockaholic.
So we said watermelon with balsamic vinegar and feta. You can make bomb-ass watermelon salad.
Someone brought that to my house recently. It was fantastic.
Tahini on watermelon is the best from Adam and Everett.
Oh, yeah.
So good. Yeah.
Rockaholics, we invite you to log in and listen to KISW for your chance to win your share of $100,000. It's very easy to do this. Just create or log into your free account on the Odyssey app and start listening. You can get more info on the contest at KISW.com. Now, we're looking for someone who is brave enough to challenge Steve. He is currently 198 wins. Inching closer to that 200.
Could happen today.
57 losses and 32 ties in 2024. 206-803-ROCK. We'll play Beat Migs at 750.
The Daily Migs Show.
Hey, it's Tiki Barber with two words any business owner wants to hear. Extra income. Amazon Hub Delivery is looking for Seattle businesses to assist with local deliveries. You get paid for each package delivered. Amazon Hub Delivery has no startup cost, no long-term contracts, and no delivery experience required. If you're a Seattle business ready to assist with local deliveries, sign up today at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
There are any number of reasons you might consider selling your home. That's where an agent who is a realtor comes in to navigate the process to sell your home in a way that's right for you. Because that's who we are. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors.
Question for you. What business couldn't use extra income? Hey, it's Tiki Barber. Right now, Amazon Hub Delivery is looking to partner with ambitious Seattle businesses to become Amazon Hub partners. You and your staff will deliver packages to customers in your area when it's convenient for you. And with each package delivered, your business gets paid. Sign up at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
A lot can happen between falling in love with a house and owning it. Having an advocate who can help you navigate negotiations, timelines, inspections, and more can make all the difference. That's what the expertise of a Realtor can do for you, because that's who we are. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
Beat Migs, don't be a loser. Beat Migs, you're a loser.
Who's ready to beat Migs? I know Chris from Salton is. Chris, are you there?
I am.
I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
Bye-bye.
For those playing at home, Chris has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
I am.
What fast food restaurant uses the slogan, "We have the meats"?
Wendy's.
No.
Arby's.
Correct. Bender is a main character from what animated TV show?
Pass.
Funko Field is the home ballpark for which local minor league baseball team?
Say again?
Funko Field is the home ballpark for which local minor league baseball team?
Uncle Sox.
Correct. In 1985, Tina Turner won a Grammy for what song?
Pass.
What recently released movie sequel is about a devastating encounter with a tornado?
Twister.
Correct. What is the smallest planet in our solar system?
Okay.
What was that?
I didn't hear the last question.
What is the smallest planet in our solar system?
Pluto.
No.
Jupiter.
No.
Pass.
Chris. Okay, well, first I need to ask Taryn and Danny. So he said Twister for the movie.
What was the question?
What recently released movie sequel is about a devastating encounter with a tornado?
Technically, that's not the right name of Twister. The movie. I'm sorry.
Chris, I can't give you that one, which means you dropped a deuce.
Ew. I've done it.
You've done it? And how did that go for you?
We'll never live it down.
I also wonder how many people are going to get mad at you for the Pluto question.
Well, you're correct. I'm not saying you're wrong. I'm just saying a lot of people still contend.
Google it, y'all.
All the astronomers are coming out.
It is not anymore. And will never be again.
Okay.
Steve, are you ready?
Yes!
What fast food restaurant uses the slogan, "We have the meats"?
We have the meats. Is that Burger King?
No.
Wendy's?
No.
Arby's?
Correct. Bender is a main character from what animated TV show?
Futurama.
Yes. Funko Field is the home ballpark for which local minor league baseball team?
Oh, man, my favorite local baseball team, the Everett Aqua Sox.
You know it. In 1985, Tina Turner won a Grammy for what song?
What year?
1985.
What's Love Got to Do with It?
Yes! What recently released movie sequel is about a devastating encounter with a tornado?
Twisters.
Yes. What is the smallest planet in our solar system?
That would be Uranus, Sarah.
No way. I do squats.
In twerk. Saturn?
No.
Mars?
No. Which country is the largest producer of wind energy? Also no. Oh.
What country?
Mm-hmm.
Of wind?
Wind energy.
I don't know. Russia.
No.
America?
No.
Canada?
No. How many seasons did The Sopranos have?
6.
Wow, yes. The boozy cocktail AMF is what color?
Green?
No.
Oh. Blue?
Yep.
Adios, mother.
Exactly. Steve, you got 6 correct, which is a win.
Yes.
6-2.
Ooh.
Sorry, Chris.
Is that your 199th win?
It is! Oh my goodness.
I could get number 200 in an hour.
I don't think any of us are prepared for that. Taryn, did you get a confetti cannon?
I did not get a confetti cannon.
How many times do I have to...
Let me just rip up some paper.
How many times do I have to ask for the confetti cannon? You guys... You were in Party City yesterday. You could have got a confetti cannon there.
Let's blame Sarah.
I would never celebrate. I mean, I would inside, but I'm always on the side for the contestant.
You're the host of it. You would be biased.
Yeah, your buddy over there should really be getting you the confetti cannon. He's always on your side.
Mm. Where's my confetti cannon, Danny?
Yeah, Danny.
Somewhere at home.
What is the smallest planet in our solar system? It is not Pluto.
Is
because
it Neptune?
That's not a planet. No.
Oh.
Earth.
No.
Venus.
Wow, we've almost named...
Mercury.
There we go.
Hey.
Ding, ding, ding. And which country is the largest producer of wind energy?
I'm going to guess China.
You would be correct. And an AMF is indeed blue. So.
Oh, I remember being in an AMF phase back in the day. I thought I was so cool ordering those.
Phase? Can we bring it back?
Sarah.
When we go to San Diego. Only AMFs.
And Long Island.
And Long Island iced teas.
No,
and
I'm out for that one.
Not a Long Island.
Shout out to Earl's Tavern in the U District.
Yeah. Oh, Earl's is great.
Gosh, those Long Islands would murder you.
Well, I feel like NAMF will, too.
Yeah, but I mean, I had many too regretful nights at Earl's because of those Long Island iced teas. I'm staying away from those.
All right, we'll order you the audio.
Did the AMF also have the Red Bull can, or is that the...
No.
That's like, I've seen those called trash can drinks.
It. Yeah.
AMF is just the beautiful blue color.
Mm-hmm.
My mouth is sweating just talking about all this. We have the most simple of questions for you, Rockaholics. All you have to do is call us up now. 206-803-ROCK. We just ask that you are in a relationship, and it's nothing dirty. It's just something simple. 206-803-ROCK. We will take your calls after Stone Temple Pilots.
The Daily Migs Show.
Lily Allen is married to David Harbour, and she recently said that FaceTiming with her husband on a regular basis can get to be a little bit too much.
My first thought is, who the hell is Lily Allen and who the hell is David Harbour? Is she a singer?
Yes.
Okay.
I think we pulled up her like big hit once. And
okay, yes.
Didn't really jam to it too hard. And then David Harbour plays what is his name in Stranger Things? He's in Stranger Things.
Okay.
Yes. So they go days without speaking to each other at all when they're apart. So this leads us to our simple question of the day. Do you talk to your partner while they are away? We're going to start with Chuck in Des Moines.
And we're
Chuck,
talking like while they're away on like a vacation.
Yeah, if you guys are apart for any reason, maybe you're on a boys' weekend, she's on a girls' weekend, a business trip. Do you guys talk while you're apart?
Well, over this weekend, it was our 28th anniversary, and she was out camping with the rest of the family while I was at home. So, no service, but we don't. On a regular basis, I mean, we might text the morning, hey, good morning, love you, all that stuff, but, eh.
Chuck,
until you get home.
I'm with you, man. Like, whenever we go to, like, anytime I leave town, like, my wife and I will text, like, good night and good morning, of course. And if anything fun happens during the day, of course, she'll text. But we tried the whole calling thing, and it was just like, what are we doing?
It's a lot.
Yeah. I'm tired.
You know, I'm too old for that stuff. If I want to FaceTime anybody, it's going to be my girlfriend.
Does your wife know about this?
Justin in Ferndale, what about Chuck? You? Do you talk to your partner when they're away?
Let's see here. Well, the last time that I had a boys' weekend, the only conversation we really had was she was looking for stuff. She was like, hey, do you know where the remote for this is? And I was like, here you go. Other than that, though, now we don't really check checking on each other.
Oh, my God.
You know what's funny is, like, sometimes, like, if Sid calls me, I'm like, why are you calling? Oh. What is going on? So it's the same with you, Danny?
No, I mean, you sound more concerned. I get mad. I'm just like, why are you FaceTiming me right now? I am busy. Do not FaceTime me. You can text me and then you tell me what you need. I get like legit angry. I'm like, why are you? Sarah does it to me as well when she's like,
toilet. She does that. I know it's weird.
It's so annoying. Why are you FaceTiming people?
We call that a crap chat.
A crap chat. Crap chat.
Scott in Seattle, do you talk to your partner when they're away?
Yeah, I mean, if there's something that's important that needs to be covered off on, but otherwise, you know, the occasional text, if something's too long for a text, we'll have a chat, but I'm certainly not FaceTime. That's just irritating.
And the funny thing is, my wife is the same way, too. If I call her, like, it's like, she's just like, you hear a tone in the voice, like, hey, like, why are you bothering me? And it's usually because, you know, we never talk on the phone when we're away from each other.
Yeah.
Now with Tatum, if my phone rings, I see a FaceTime, I'm like, oh, it's got to be Tatum. And if it's not, I'm disappointed. I'm just like, where's our child?
Well, shout out to all the Droid users that do video chat instead of FaceTime. Love you.
Okay.
Sorry, do you chat with, like, when we go to our radio conventions, are you chatting with George?
When I'm faded. When I'm faded, I love FaceTiming because I just want to see his cute face.
I bet he loves it, too.
He hates it so much. And the moment he answers, he's like, you're faded, aren't you? I'm like, no.
Oh, boy.
But that's it.
All those AMFs.
Yes.
Now, Sarah, a question for you. Are you watching the new Bachelorette season?
I just started over this past weekend.
So are you up to date?
Sure I'm not.
Sure are not. Okay, well, we're not going to spoil anything.
Bob
for
got
you.
Eliminated.
I loved Bob.
Is there a guy named Bob?
I don't know.
Yes, I got crap. Did I just screw it up just by cracking a stupid joke?
Apparently, there is something that has happened on the show, and many people say they are done with the Bachelorette because of it. So we're going to go straight to the comments at 8:20.
The Daily Migs Show.
Hey, it's Tiki Barber with a special message for Seattle businesses looking to diversify your income. Amazon Hub Delivery is making it easy to earn extra money. When you partner with Amazon Hub Delivery, you and your staff will deliver packages to customers in your area. With each package delivered, you'll gain extra income and exposure for your business. There's no upfront cost, no delivery experience, and no long-term contracts required. Sign up to learn more at Amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's Amazon.com/HUB delivery.
Selling a little or a lot? Shopify helps you do your thing, however you cha-ching. Shopify is the global commerce platform that helps you sell at every stage of your business. From the launch your online shop stage, to the first real-life store stage, all the way to the did we just hit a million orders stage. Shopify is here to help you grow. Whether you're selling scented soap or offering outdoor outfits, Shopify helps you sell everywhere. From their all-in-one e-commerce platform to their in-person POS system, wherever and whatever you're selling, Shopify's got you covered. Shopify helps you turn browsers into buyers with the internet's best converting checkout. 15% better on average compared to other leading commerce platforms. And sell more with less effort thanks to Shopify Magic, your AI-powered all-star. Shopify powers 10% of all e-commerce in the U.S. And Shopify is the global force behind Allbirds, Rothy's, and Brooklinen, and millions of other entrepreneurs of every size across 175 countries. Plus, Shopify's award-winning 24/7 help is there to support your success every step of the way. Because businesses that grow, grow with Shopify. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/odysseypodcast, all lowercase. Go to shopify.com/odysseypodcast now to grow your business, no matter what stage you're in. shopify.com/odysseypodcast.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
If you've not already done so, download the Odyssey app for your smartphone. It's very easy to do, and you're going to listen to KISW anyway. So log in and listen on the Odyssey app. That is your chance to win your share of $100,000.
A lot of money.
It is a ton of money. And it's very easy. Just create or log into your free account on the Odyssey app, and you can get more info on the contest at KISW.com.
Everyone knows social media is a time suck, and what you're about to hear proves it. If it's online, someone, somewhere has an opinion and is whining about it. So let's get straight to the comments.
The Bachelorette had to put out a disclaimer on their social media pages for their most recent episode. Did that air last night?
Yes, Monday night.
Monday night.
Forgive my ignorance. Ugh. Is The Bachelorette the one where there's a bunch of chicks trying to bang one dude, or is it a bunch of dudes trying to hook up with one girl?
A bunch of dudes trying to hook up with one girl.
Okay, that's what I figured, but yep. I just wanted to make sure.
So this is what the disclaimer read. I love this. Tonight's episode of The Bachelorette contains images of a graphic nature, including scantily clad men thrusting and gyrating. Woo! If you have a weak heart or raging libido, viewer discretion is advised.
Which is funny, because that's how they describe Monday Night Raw for the WWE as well.
So many are not happy with the new season, so we must go straight to the comments.
We sent this post, because it's just a graphic, and it says that. We sent it to Jason, our production director, a.k.a. Veggie Dog, a.k.a. VD, and said, pick out some of your favorite comments about this, and recreate them however you want. And of course he did. Are you ready for the first comment?
Oh, yeah.
All right, here we go.
Stripping don't have a dang thing to do with a relationship that could lead to an engagement or marriage. Each season seeps lower and lower. Can't believe I still watch this.
Does anyone really think that this is always going to end in a happy marriage?
Yes.
Do you believe that?
I do.
Sarah loves
I have
love.
Hope every new season, Steve.
Next comment.
Why do people still watch this? How is this fun to watch? Bunch of f***ing dorks trying to play hide the eggplant, but acting like they want love. Admit it, you want fame and sex.
Because you're all just a whore.
Wow. Them's fighting words.
Who doesn't want fame and sex?
Agree with the other commenters. This season is so ick. I want to watch mature relationships unfold. This season is embarrassing. I can't even get into it. Because it's not real, you moron!
Jason's finally had it. Jason's had it.
If that person is into mature relationships, maybe they should watch The Golden Bachelorette when that starts.
Right?
Yeah.
Thanks for the warning! I was watching last week's episode, and my 5-year-old daughter had lots of questions. Will not be watching with her awake. Besides, mommy needs some sanity juice and some alone time.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was Jason's commentary at the end of that one. But who's watching The Bachelorette with their child?
0% chance I'm doing that.
No. I've got to watch Bluey.
Of course.
A good show.
Yeah.
About real relationships.
Morals.
Yes.
This is ridiculous. Why? My mother won't watch this. I'm embarrassed to watch it with her. And we love softcore.
Jason has lost his mind.
After leaving New Kids on the Block Friday night, mainly because of too much thrusting, I'm good.
Wait, leaving New Kids on the Block because of too much thrusting?
Yeah.
What did you think was going to happen?
Let me get on Ticketmaster and get some New Kids on the Block tickets.
Right?
Yeah, we have one more comment. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Dumb ass bullshit. Stripping ain't got a damn thing to do with whether two people are attracted to each other to get to an engagement leading to marriage. Bachelorette gets more dumbass. What are you expecting?
Have a great day.
Okay, thank you.
I honestly am so excited to watch last night's episode now.
So this is a bunch of dudes gyrating.
Yeah. Eggplants. Probably take their shirts off. I've never been so stoked.
I can't wait for your full review tomorrow, Sarah.
Oh, God.
Can we do that like sometime after 10 or before 6 a.m.?
Probably. A Secret Service was told that they are full of S in the most epic of ways. We're going to tell you what's trending after Pink Floyd.
The Daily Mix Show.
Question for you. What business couldn't use extra income? Hey, it's Tiki Barber. Right now, Amazon Hub Delivery is looking to partner with ambitious Seattle businesses to become Amazon Hub partners. You and your staff will deliver packages to customers in your area when it's convenient for you. And with each package delivered, your business gets paid. Sign up at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
What kind of programs does this school have? How are the test scores? How many kids do a classroom? Homes.com knows these are all things you ask when you're home shopping as a parent. That's why each listing on Homes.com includes extensive reports on local schools, including photos, parent reviews, test scores, student-teacher ratio, school rankings, and more. The information is from multiple trusted sources and curated by Homes.com's dedicated in-house research team. It's all so you can make the right decision for your family. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
Hey, it's Tiki Barber with two words any business owner wants to hear. Extra income. Amazon Hub Delivery is looking for Seattle businesses to assist with local deliveries. You get paid for each package delivered. Amazon Hub Delivery has no startup cost, no long-term contracts, and no delivery experience required. If you're a Seattle business ready to assist with local deliveries, sign up today at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
I have a to-do list for you, Rockaholics. Step one, download the Odyssey app. Step two, log in and listen to KISW. Step three, you have a shot at winning your share of $100,000. It could not be easier. So go ahead and create or even log in to your existing free Odyssey account and then start streaming The Rock of Seattle. More info on the contest at KISW.com.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
Beat Migs, don't be a loser. Beat Migs, you're a loser.
Who's ready to beat Migs? I know Leah from Bothell is. Leah, are you there?
I'm here.
I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
Bye-bye.
For those playing at home, Leah has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you will only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Yes.
Which civil rights leader made the famous I Have a Dream speech?
Martin Luther King Jr.
Correct. What kind of nut is in a Baby Ruth bar?
Oh, peanut?
Yes. Okay. What band had the hit song Float On?
Foo Fighters?
No.
Pass.
What Parks and Recreation actor recently tore her ACL during the WNBA All-Star Weekend?
Oh, no. Pass.
What is the medical term for your shin bone?
Shin bone. Oh, my goodness. Pass.
What company uses this? Bounty is correct. Chester Bennington passed away in what year?
2012?
No.
2011, 2013.
No. What is the official currency in France?
Euros?
Correct. In Lord of the Rings, how many rings of power are there in total?
10, 11, 12.
No. Chanterelle and oyster are both types of what food item?
I don't know, soup?
No.
Ooh, I'm going to go ahead and put her on hold.
You got
Potty Mouth Leah is what we're calling her.
Our heart's racing. And not only did she, well, she got 4 correct, first of all.
Okay.
But she also, not only did she like drop a bad word, it was like the bad word.
The King Mother.
Yes.
Wow.
If you're gonna go for it. I mean, she went for it. I support this, but
this is one reason to listen on the Odyssey app. Yeah. You get to hear the
uncensored version.
The uncensored version.
Yeah, sure do.
Of Beat Migs.
That's one way to sell something. Download the Odyssey app. Hear bad words and potentially win money.
That was perfect. Honestly, I love bad words and money. So
I mean,
two of my favorite things.
Yeah.
Steve, are you ready? Which civil rights leader made the famous I Have a Dream speech?
Martin Luther King Jr.
Correct. What kind of nut is in a Baby Ruth bar?
D's.
No, thank goodness.
Almonds?
No.
Peanuts.
Yes. What band had the hit song Float On?
Modest Mouse.
You know it. What Parks and Recreation actor recently tore her ACL during the WNBA All-Star Weekend?
Oh, crap. Chris Pratt.
No.
Who else is in that show? Aubrey Plaza.
Yes. What is the medical term for your shin bone?
The femur.
No.
Oh. The leg.
No.
The...
Yes, that is the medical term.
Shinoli.
No.
Wow.
What company uses the slogan, the quicker picker upper?
Bounty.
Yes. Chester Bennington passed away in what year?
Ooh. 2019?
No.
2020?
No.
2018?
Nope. What is the official currency in France?
Euros.
Correct. In Lord of the Rings, how many rings of power are there in total?
Is somebody doing origami in this room? I have my blindfold on. I just keep hearing paper being folded. What was it?
In Lord of the Rings, how many rings of power are there in total?
One.
No. Everyone thinks that, but it's not one. Steve, it was not origami. I know what it was. Because you, my friend, got six correct, which is a win.
Yes.
Big win.
That's our confetti get in.
For your 200. And for those who don't know, Danny and Taryn just showered him in beautiful paper.
It was the most low-budget confetti cannon you've ever
seen. You guys were literally ripping it while I was playing the game.
They didn't have faith in you, I think, until they heard Leah's performance. And they were like, uh-oh.
Heard her bad word.
Yes.
Wow. Congrats, Steve. That's very impressive.
200.
That was so anticlimactic. That'd be like winning the Stanley Cup and they forgot the cup and they just brought out like one of those thermoses, the Stanley Cup thermos, and said, you know what, guys, the best we can do. Just skid around the ice and pretend we'll fix it in editing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to throw a confetti cannon for the podcast. You'll hear an actual confetti cannon.
Okay, you edited that in?
Yeah.
I appreciate you.
What is the medical term for your shin bone?
That would be the
tibia.
Tibia.
Tibia, I said.
You always combine them because there's a tibia and a fibula. But it's just tibia. Chester Bennington passed away because everyone made it a, you know, Chris Cornell had his birthday. Chester Bennington, it was his 7 year.
2017?
Correct.
2017. It's been that long.
Isn't that wild?
Yeah.
In Lord of the Rings, how many rings of power are there in total?
Four?
20.
Oh.
I am not a Lord of the Rings girl, and I was shocked by this. I thought there was just one.
I thought Gollum was all about that one ring. It's precious.
It's precious. And I guess there's 20 of them. And chanterelle and oyster are both types of what food item?
Chanterelle and oyster? Mushrooms.
Mm-hmm. There
that,
we go.
That was me that said that. Yeah, I got you, Steve. Thank you.
Steve was not going to get that.
No, he was so confused.
But congratulations on your 200th win.
Thank you. Wow. Thank you, you guys.
For your 300th win, I will get confetti cannons if that ever happens.
No, you won't.
Shush, Sarah.
And of course it's going to happen.
I'll hold you guys
There's only
up
a
to
few
that.
Months left. I mean, there's a few months you can do that.
He's just right. Too good. Oh, boy.
You deserve this.
Thank you.
And it's just you are the champion.
Yep. Over the weekend, the movie Twisters was a huge hit at the box office. But would you say it is the best disaster movie of all time?
That's a good question.
Well, there's a member of this show that had a movie that traumatized him as a child. And what was it? We're going to tell you after Nirvana.
Daily Migs Show.
Twisters was massively successful at the box office over the weekend. I think it was 81 million.
Yes, over 80 million. I keep hearing great things about it. People are saying this is an awesome movie.
None of us have seen it yet. I mean, I think I have better luck of seeing Despicable Me 4 than Twisters at this time in my life. But
the odds are not in my favor. For a while, I won't be able to check this out.
But apparently, it was such a good movie, they've already put it on the list of the best disaster movies of all time.
Ooh, that gets you thinking, like, what is the ultimate disaster film?
Well, it came in at number four. Let me give you the others. The top five. Number one, The Towering Inferno.
Has anybody seen this movie?
I saw it once a really long time ago. That's with the skyscraper in San Francisco or whatever.
State-of-the-art building, and then it catches fire. It just freaks you out. Dude, I mean, I was a kid. Now, the movie came out in 74, so it was before I was born. But I remember being a kid. It was like one of those movies that network TV would always show. So sometimes you just got sucked into watching it. I remember being a kid and watching it. I was completely traumatized for the rest of my life. Or at least, you know, as a child, anywhere I went, I was afraid that the building was going to catch on fire.
Oh, that's awful.
I found the trailer. You want to talk about, like, how dated things sound? This trailer is crazy.
Steve McQueen and Paul Newman race against time as one tiny spark becomes a night of blazing suspense. The Towering Inferno.
It's out of control. It's coming your way.
I'll be back with the whole fire department.
The Towering
towering inferno.
Set me down on the scenic elevator.
There's like 15 explosions before in this Australia. You're just like, my gosh, the whole world's coming to an end.
Well, number two on the list is one that I also watched in my youth, and I actually had this movie on VHS, so I think I must be some sort of a psycho or something. The Poseidon Adventure with Gene Hackman, and it was where the cruise ship was getting like put to bed.
Yes.
And it gets taken out by a tsunami, and they're all trapped inside.
Here's the crazy part. The people who created the Poseidon Adventure made the Towering Inferno.
Of course.
They're just trying to scare people both in the water and on land. These bastards.
Number three on the list, I also had on VHS, and that was Twister.
Twister, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Then number four is Twisters, plural. Mm-hmm. And then number five, Armageddon.
Armageddon. Is that the one, the asteroids?
With Bruce Willis.
Yeah. I believe so.
And Liv Tyler plays the daughter.
Yeah.
Is that what the Aerosmith song came from?
I could stay away.
I haven't seen any of these movies.
Dude, I don't think you need to.
You know what you know what the number one disaster movie is, though? Titanic.
Oh, kind of surprised it's not on here.
Right?
Wait, it should that's be. True.
Yeah, it's a whole disaster movie.
The Poseidon Adventure is way more disastrous than the Titanic.
I'd rather watch The Towering Inferno on a loop than ever see one sitting of Titanic.
Steve, it'll destroy your heart, okay?
Okay. So we just texted him some. Dude, I remember seeing that movie as well when I was a kid on television, too. I had nightmares about fires and being caught in one and not being able to get out for at least a week.
That's horrible.
Another texter says, yeah, my mom made me watch that movie, and both of us refused to take any elevators after seeing it. The movie is terrifying.
Yeah, these are what nightmares are made out of.
I was also, though, I remember watching, like, it was like The Burning Bed. Do you remember that one?
No.
It was about a woman who was scorned, I think, and she set her house on fire to get back at her husband. And so I was like convinced that was that's what relationships were.
Oh.
Like, television really messed with my head.
Have you been to therapy, Steve?
I think I am right now. I'm letting it all out.
If it's not toxic, we're not really in love.
Did you find The Burning
Bed?
What's the synopsis say?
Suffers an abuse from her husband for almost a decade because she cannot find any help when drunkenly. Her husband does something really bad to her and then passes out. And so she pours gasoline all over him and lights the house on fire. That's so funny.
This was just on TV.
That is psycho.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, if you do something bad, you're going to get burned.
I feel like that was just like, do we have another movie about fire? Cool. Put it on at 8 p.m. tonight.
Oh, Farrah Fawcett, though. I was like, she's beautiful. Yes. Okay, she played the main character.
There's a few of those kind of movies where I felt like they were just constantly on network television. So we're just like, well, we don't have cable. We have no other way to watch anything. This is way before streaming, of course. You're like, all right, I guess I'll watch this movie about a building burning down.
Oh, my goodness.
You might consider yourself to be a massive music fan, Rockaholics, but do you think that you could name a song after only hearing 1 second of the chorus? Prove that to us. And if you do, you will win tickets to see Megadeth at White River Amphitheater on August 12th. 206-803-ROCK. We'll be playing Hook or Shook at 9:20.
The Daily Mix Show.
Hey, it's Tiki Barber with two words any business owner wants to hear. Extra income. Amazon Hub Delivery is looking for Seattle businesses to assist with local deliveries. You get paid for each package delivered. Amazon Hub Delivery has no startup cost, no long-term contracts, and no delivery experience required. If you're a Seattle business ready to assist with local deliveries, sign up today at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
Selling a little or a lot? Shopify helps you do your thing, however you cha-ching. Shopify is the global commerce platform that helps you sell at every stage of your business. From the launch your online shop stage, to the first real-life store stage, all the way to the did we just hit a million orders stage. Shopify is here to help you grow. Whether you're selling scented soap or offering outdoor outfits, Shopify helps you sell everywhere. From their all-in-one e-commerce platform to their in-person POS system, wherever and whatever you're selling, Shopify has got you covered. Shopify helps you turn browsers into buyers with the internet's best converting checkout. 15% better on average compared to other leading commerce platforms. And sell more with less effort thanks to Shopify Magic, your AI-powered all-star. Shopify powers 10% of all e-commerce in the U.S. And Shopify is the global force behind Allbirds, Rothy's, and Brooklinen, and millions of other entrepreneurs of every size across 175 countries. Plus, Shopify's award-winning 24/7 help is there there to support your success every step of the way. Because businesses that grow, grow with Shopify. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/odysseypodcast, all lowercase. Go to shopify.com/odysseypodcast now to grow your business, no matter what stage you're in. Shopify.com/odysseypodcast.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
The Daily Mix Show presents the Extreme Music Showdown. Let's play Hook or Shook. Please sign this waiver before we continue. Thank you. We'll drop a 1 second snippet of the hook of a song. If you can't name the song, watch out. You're gonna get shook.
It is time to play Hook or Shook. Danny is going to play 1 second of a hook from a song that he picked, and your job is to guess what it is. This week, we are playing for tickets to see Megadeth with Mudvayne at White River Amphitheater, and that show is on August 12th. Let's say hello to Steve in McCleary. Good morning, Steve.
Good morning.
We like your name.
It's the best name Thank ever.
So you've got to get both songs right to win. The first one, you'll be on your own. The second one, this is where you can get shook because a member of our show at random has to get it right for you. If not, you will lose and caller 9 will get the tickets instead. Let's see who you are competing with this morning. Me, Migs, or Sarah?
All right, the wheels are going. All right, just passed Tyron's name and landed on, oh, Sarah.
No!
So sorry, Steve.
Heck yeah, let's do it.
You know, the optimism.
She's had some great performances lately.
Yep.
Yeah, let's go, Sarah.
You know what? Thanks, Steve. I love this.
See, at least one Steve believes in you.
Just one. That's all you need. All right, Steve, here is your clip. Oh.
Ooh. Yeah, let's hear that again.
You got it?
I know this one.
Steve, do you have any idea, or do you need Sarah's help?
No, I don't. Oh, other Steve.
Other Steve.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Other Steve.
I have no idea either.
No, yeah, it's not coming through very well.
Gwen Stefani was in this band.
Okay, so No Doubt.
Woo-woo!
Let's hear it again. Oh, now I hear it like playing. Could I not hear that?
She's literally about to say the title of the song.
Well, it sounds okay. I want to guess, but I feel like I just don't want to throw it away. So I'm going to need a hint for the.
Okay, it's a nice way to tell you to shut up.
Don't speak.
Yeah.
Yes. Great hint. Sarah's the new ringer.
Yep.
Also. I love that Danny played No Doubt. That's perfect for me.
I will forever love this song because it's about the bassist in the band, and it's like this like FU to him. And he had to play this song on tour with her forever, and it's their biggest hit. I just think there's something just so bitter and awesome about that.
Yes, sir. All right, Steve, are you ready for Sarah, sorry. Are you ready for your clip?
I guess so.
And Steve can help if we need him. Here we go.
Oh, man, we're going right back to the 90s, baby.
Ooh. Wait.
Oh, yeah.
I got a good hint if we want to have no integrity.
Does Steve, does our competitor Steve know the song and the artist?
I think, but I would have to really dig deep and think.
See,
so very familiar with the song.
Sarah was singing it.
Yeah.
Okay. Does the second word of the song rhyme with bones?
It sure does.
Also, for the hint, just to give a little love to one of our great listeners, you know we have that teacher that always texts in?
Yes! Her name.
Right, but...
instead of a female.
Oh, Mr. Jones?
That's the song.
That's why I wanted to give a hint. I just wanted to show some love to Mrs. Jones because she's like one of my favorite people that texts in.
Okay, Mr. Jones. Yeah, it's a great song.
Okay. Who is it by?
Steve, who's a bye?
Well, he's going to
give me a hint.
Steve, who's a bye?
Okay.
The second word of the band name, these birds are referred to as a murder of...
Ooh, crows. Mm. Are we doing some numbers?
And when you're counting crows. Adding numbers.
Are we doing some numbers, people?
You know we're doing numbers.
Yeah, some dream team action right there, Steve and Sarah.
When don't we do numbers?
Right? Wow, the Steve's really helped me out. Thank you to both of you.
Congrats, Steve. You're going to see Megadeth with Mudvayne at White River on August 12th. Now,
it's
going
to be a great pairing with Metallica is all I got to say. That's going to be awesome. Ooh.
Dude, hell yeah, man. A little thrash fest right there.
Good month, for sure. Now, if we have talked about something this morning that you want to talk about, Rockaholics, please do give us a call now. 206-803-ROCK. We will be checking in with the Rockaholics after Alice in Chains.
The Daily Mix Show. The Daily Mix Show.
Thank you for texting and calling us this morning, Rockaholics. We are now checking in with the Rockaholics, so please do give us a call and let us know what's on your mind today. Anything we've hit on the show or anything you want to chime in on. 206-803-ROCK. Ethan in Montana, last night you went to Primus in Montana.
Yes, I did. That was a great show.
I looked at the set list. You guys got a Jalekit in the encore. I'm very jealous.
Yes, we did. They came out after they played. They're like, well, we were talking about it backstage. They're like, well, we should do something we haven't done in a really long time. And that's what they gave us.
Oh, I'm so jealous. So you had a great time.
What song is, what the hell, what?
Jalekit.
Jalekit? Like,
Jalekit.
They were like, this is something we probably haven't done in like 30 years. So
I looked it up. It looked like they had not played that song since 2004 live. So it had been a minute.
And I partially think that was responsible. We had a bit of a lightning delay all of a sudden right at the beginning of it.
I feel like that's happening everywhere right now. The weather is delaying shows all over the country. But
yeah,
you were happy with it? It was a good one?
Oh, it was great. I saw his solo with the Fearless Flying Frogs last summer,
yeah.
Which was a great show, too. We got Whamala, which is awesome, because they don't play out Primus, obviously.
I feel like Primus is just speaking a different language than the names of their songs. I don't remember them having such strange song titles, but then again, I haven't really listened to a lot of their stuff since Sailing the Seas for Cheese.
Yeah, they're weirdos, for sure.
Well, that I could have confirmed as well.
We were talking earlier today
I want to see them live.
Let's go next time.
Next time, I'll go with you.
We'll go. Field trip.
Shucks.
Earlier talking about weird food combinations, and Austin in Renton wants to chime in on this. What is your weird food combo?
Pepperoni and syrup.
Like maple syrup?
Yeah.
Do you put it on your pizza as like a condiment, or do you just dip pepperoni in syrup?
No, it was me and my buddies were hanging out, and he was out of food. He had a big old bag of pepperoni, and we were eating it. I got bored, and I was like, put some syrup on the plate, too. And so I just dipped it into the syrup and ate it, and it was surprisingly really good.
You know, I do love a salty sweet combo, so I can see how that would work.
I mean, it doesn't sound terrible. They're both delicious, so. Someone texted in and said my son used to like jelly and cheddar cheese sandwiches in his lunch.
Weird.
Remember the people who were like, was it butter and jelly, I think, or mayo and jelly? It wasn't peanut butter, but it was like something else. I always thought that was such a strange combo.
Well, Brooklyn and Marysville also has a weird combo.
Brooklyn.
Pickles and peanut butter.
Okay. Are we talking dill pickles or sweet pickles?
It has to be the Clausen sandwich slice pickles.
Ooh.
And are we talking crunchy peanut butter or creamy? Ooh.
Smooth honey roasted peanut butter.
Oh. Wait, they have honey roasted peanut butter?
I think it's Skippy. My father-in-law used to buy it, and that's how I found it. But my mom, the only thing she could handle when she was pregnant with me was either 7-Eleven nachos or pickles and peanut butter.
What?
So they think the taste buds somehow like transferred during pregnancy. It was so weird. I don't know. My fiance still gags when I eat it.
Yeah, there it is. Skippy roasted honey nut peanut butter.
You just don't knock it till you try it.
No, I mean, I love like the peanuts, the honey roasted peanuts.
Oh, yeah.
Or honey roasted almonds. Those are all great.
Also, I want to throw something out real quick. Have you noticed that all this morning, Steve has asked our listeners if they're talking dill pickles or sweet pickles?
Yeah.
Steve, no one's talking sweet pickles because they're the worst.
So sandwich pickles are sweet pickles.
I don't think they are.
The ones I get are.
No taste buds over there.
Okay, Danny.
Hi.
Steve, this might be the first time we've ever uttered these words on the Daily Migs show. I think Sarah might be right.
About what?
Exactly. It involves texting, and we're going to tell you all about it at 9:50. There is a first time for everything. You guys, Sarah might be right.
This ain't the first time.
She mentioned this yesterday, and now we know for a fact that there is a chance that if you're getting a text asking for a political donation, it might actually be a scammer trying to get your credit card information.
So what were we talking about yesterday? That was the scam that was going on. It was the jury duty scam where they're saying, hey, you know, if someone calls and says you owe all this money and you don't pay it right now, the authorities are going to kick down your door and arrest you or charge you $7,500. And it turns out that's just a giant scam. And then, Sarah, you brought up the fact that you're a little hesitant to even click on any of these political texts that you've been getting.
Yeah, because it sounds like they're from real people, and I've gotten a few of them, but I don't like to click, so I just delete.
The Better Business Bureau says that the election-themed scam texts are huge right now.
You should be like, listen, Kamala, unless you FaceTime me, I'm not responding to this text.
Yeah.
And sometimes they're not even asking for money, though. They're just asking you to click on a link and you can, like, accept a free gift or something like that. All of it is bad. Don't do
it. Oh, because then they're like, hey, you got to pay the shipping. Next thing you know, you hand over your information and boom, scammed. I also saw people are getting scammed because of what's going on with the blue screen of death, with all the stuff that's with the tech shutdown. Because people are getting text messages saying, hey, insert this information because you're at risk. You know, you have a security risk or whatever it may be. And people are falling for that, too. Oh, man. I just can't believe anyone.
Scammers are ruthless. We trust no one anymore.
I haven't responded to my mom's text in 2 years because I believe that she's scamming me. That, and she doesn't have a cell phone, so I think it's weird.
Why would someone put a bird into a tortilla? What? We're going to talk about this during the Daily Migs download after the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
The Daily Migs Show. Knowledge is power. So give us five-ish minutes and we'll give you some interesting stuff you can talk about at work. This is the Daily Migs download,
aka the DMD.
Here's your daily dose of doings happening in the world.
And the DMD is brought to you by Palace Lawn. Yesterday, your Seattle Mariners freaking blew it. Wow. Right at the end, too. The last couple of innings were just not pretty. They ended up losing 3-1, wasting a great game by pitcher Bryce Miller. He pitched 7 scoreless innings for the Mariners and just looked phenomenal. But the Astros lost as well, so at least we didn't lose any ground when it comes to this battle between them two for the AL West. But the Rangers won, and now all of a sudden they're starting to nip at the butts of both of these teams. So it's going to be a 3-team race going into the end of the season, which is kind of bonkers. They play again tonight against the Anaheim Angels or Los Angeles Angels. But more importantly, your Seattle Mariners are playing tomorrow afternoon at T-Mobile Park, and all of us from the show are going to be there. So if you're going to the game or thinking about going to the game, come hang out with us. We have no idea where we're sitting, but that doesn't matter because we'll be hanging out in the pen for pretty much the entire game.
It's my favorite place.
I love that place. And always meet some great rockaholics when we're over by the pen.
A family in Texas thought very quickly and wrapped a baby bird in a warm tortilla until animal experts could get there. They found the baby bird on Saturday while they were barbecuing in their yard, and then they noticed that this animal appeared to be very cold. So the mom thought, hey, put the tortilla on the grill, and then they used it as a little bird burrito blanket.
But, oh, tortilla. Dude, I thought you said the bird on the grill for a second. I was like, what are we doing?
No, just a big tortilla. They wrapped the little baby bird up, and then even the animal experts that came to fetch the bird were like, hey, that worked. The bird's going to be fine. It's a native bird to Texas called a Mississippi kite.
And it's in Texas.
Yes.
It's like rattlesnake ledge or whatever that is here. There's no rattlesnake.
But they have named the bird Taquito.
Okay. That's a great name for the bird.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, a human finger was found in Tacoma, so, well, congratulations to whoever lost their finger, because apparently they found it. This happened on July 5th, so a lot of people believe, yeah, it had to be because of a fireworks accident. The weird part was there was no record of any kind of injury of the sort with that finger being missing on the 4th of July, so people were like, what the hell is going on? Eventually, because the story ended up becoming not just a local story, but also became a national story as well, but eventually the owner of the finger is like, oh, wait, that's my finger. I should contact whoever it is that has it right now, and came forward to claim his body part. Now, they haven't named who this person is. I don't know if they're able to get that finger back on the person as well, But the person did say that they did injure themselves with fireworks.
I cannot imagine that there was any way to reattach that finger like 3 weeks later or whatever.
Not even if they kept it cold?
I don't think so. So then my curious brain is, what are you going to do with the finger? Are you going to put it in like a jar of formaldehyde?
Make it into a keychain.
Wear it as a medallion.
A necklace? That'd be pretty badass. But where's your finger? And then you just like tear open your shirt. You're like, it's right here, brother. Hey, as far as weather, we're going to hit a high of 73 or 74 degrees today. It's going to be a nice sunny day. The DMD is brought to you by Kia of Puyallup, and that's what's up.
Our friend Ryan Castle is up next with your morning 12-pack.
The Daily Mix Show.
Question for you. What business couldn't use extra income? Hey, it's Tiki Barber. Right now, Amazon Hub Delivery is looking to partner with ambitious Seattle businesses to become Amazon Hub partners. You and your staff will deliver packages to customers in your area when it's convenient for you. And with each package delivered, your business gets paid. Sign up at amazon.com/hubdelivery. That's amazon.com/HUB delivery.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.